Time for another part of Let's Play Berseria. So now we gotta get back to Tabitha after we technically killed Gideon. So now we can just leave. So let's get on out of here. Right this way.
Stealing a Moloch from an exorcist. How did you pull that one off, Moggy Lou?
The info was my Moloch to begin with. Then he betrayed me from his rightful home.
Miss Moggy Lou treats Malakhim so bad, bad, bad. I couldn't take it anymore. After a little while, I ran into Madame Eleanor. She was so much nicer to me.
I see, I see.
I don't really care for mascot characters, but their interaction is very good.
You're an exorcist, then.
I'm a witch, silly. The info here is the catalyst thingy for my magic.
But only exorcists.
Catalyst thingy. It's a technical term.
Oh, yeah? Says who? Someone who likes making dumb rules?
Enough, Velvet. Questioning.
I would agree with that. So, since we went through that, let's just save real quick here. Just so we don't have to go through all that again. Okay. So head back. Sweet. What else we got? Okay, so that was the pill bug thing. Okay, so we got some stuff. Cool. Wait. Whoops. That's what I was looking for.
You did the job well, it seems.
You heard quickly.
That's about all I'm good for. And with these old ears, sometimes it's hard to hear it all.
And did you learn anything about the key for passing through the barrier?
Yes. Only the high-ranking exorcists.
Naturally.
Protecting Artorias and his temple. Exorcists are considered high-ranking if they are accompanied by at least 4 greater Malakhim.
So if we had 4 powerful Malakhim with us, we could slip through.
But Malakhim outside the Abbey's control are rare. They thought this through.
Well, I may not look it, but I'm a greater Moloch.
Aizen, Lafiset, and Bienfu. So we just need one more.
We'll have to steal it then.
So I have to come too? Sounds like a pain.
Then stay. We don't need you. We'll keep Bienfu though.
You have no courtesy. How about it would be an honor, Madame Moggy Lou? More like that.
Would you come if we asked? To attack the shepherd?
Depends on how you ask. A battle between shepherd and demon sounds like a real fine spectacle.
I'm afraid this is just how Miss Moggy Lou is.
Miss Moggy Lou, I would like it if...
There you go.
Please.
Luffy said.
Well, what choice does that leave me? I suppose I could tag along a little while longer.
You can count on me.
Melchior will be there. You and I still share the same goal.
Our business is done. You can have this back.
Keep it, dear. As long as you have that, we will count you as an ally worthy of aid.
Very nice.
Allies of the ones trying to kill the Savior? You might regret that.
Such a considerate young lady. Listen, dear, all of us live on the fringes of their so-called reason, do we not?
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Velvet, wait.
My, my.
I can't blame him. It's been a long night.
Some aid for your allies?
Of course. Right away.
You're finally up.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it. Getting sleepy or hungry is a natural part of life. I won't eat you.
What about your wounds? Feeling pain?
That's true.
Right?
I'm fine. It was nothing.
You're really tough, aren't you, Velvet?
You have to be tough. What you seek is revenge.
Revenge?
We're leaving. Rokuro and the others are waiting at the plaza.
Joy to face a clear, refreshing morning, especially after a long night of meting punishment on my heartless betrayer. My poor, battered body.
You better not kill our key.
You're one to talk. Better not eat the boy. He's your precious key now.
I know.
Oh? You're facing the Shepherd and an Empyrean. Old Shepsy's one thing, but Empyreans are, you know, just gods who created the world. You think you can win just by smacking it around a bit?
That's no Empyrean. It's a phony. Artorias is just using a legend to control the people. Wouldn't a true god be able to do something about the demon blight?
She's got a point.
You don't believe in Enominat?
I believe there exists something people call Enominat. But it's just a Moloch that used a special art to bring the other Malakhim into our world.
You sound confident.
I witnessed it 3 years ago.
Well, if it's not actually a god we're against,
yeah,
we just might stand a chance.
Of course we do.
Although I have faced gods before.
Target is Artorias. I don't care about anything else.
Revenge against Artorias. For her brother.
All right, Lafayette. Which way is the Empyrean's throne?
It was north of Logris, in the mountains up the Danann Highway.
If exorcists are keeping up their inspections, they might provide us a chance to steal another Moloch.
I sent my men a Sylph-Jay with orders to scout out the inspectors. With their information, we'll be able to plan the attack.
We can meet up at Port Zexen.
That's the plan.
Perfect.
Those Sylph Jays are handy little birds, aren't they?
Not only will they always find their destination, they can make for emergency rations in a pinch. Rather well with a nice glass of the hard stuff.
It's because of the work those birds do for us that we're able to stay one step ahead of the Abbey. Those birds are indispensable to us pirates.
Hey, if you're stuck somewhere, man.
Do their thing. I know that carrier pigeons rely on their homing instincts, but Sylph Jays can locate a person wherever they are, right?
They're really smart birds. I read in a book that rather than memorizing locations, They can pick up on people's wavelengths. When you send out a Sylph Jay, the bird can sense the change in your thoughts, and will seek out...
I wouldn't be surprised if Sylph Jays turned out to be a Moloch.
...see them in the wild. Are they a kind of Moloch or something?
No, they're not Malakhim. They're just an incredibly rare species.
That's incredibly vague.
It's a funny story. A chance storm sent us docking at that island, and a mother Sylph Jay got blown onto our ship, eggs, nest, and all. Sadly, the mother bird died almost immediately. But Benwick stepped in and kept her eggs safe and warm.
So that's why they're so attached to him. Usually, they're really hard to train as messenger birds, too.
That's Benwick for you. He's always had a knack for things that would give other people trouble.
Maybe when they hatched, they took one look at his wild hair and mistook him for their
nest. It's possible.
They are comfortable enough with him to use his head for their nest. So you might have a point. Now that you mention it, he did ask me not to hit him on the head, because one of the Sylph Jays just laid her eggs.
Well, if more birds are on the way, we could just eat one to see how it tastes.
No! Don't even
think about it. It was worth a try.
I still want to eat one.
Should be no surprise. You've got a lot of power, despite your appearance. You're a greater Moloch too, aren't you, Aizen?
So I've been told, but I can't say I care for measures made by folks who tether my kind.
I didn't know that's what it was.
I'm sorry.
No, don't worry about it. Just promise me you won't judge your own value from a look given to you by others.
I won't. I promise.
What if that's all that gives me self-worth?
They're pirates and demons. Pay them no heed. To me, you are the greatest of all.
The greatest? Do you really mean it? Oh, Miss Mogulu, you're so kind! You've changed so much since I left.
But you haven't changed at all. You are eternally my greatest servant.
Oh, I don't want to be the greatest then! Oh, this is bad, bad!
And our roster of the oblivious grows...
Yeah. Whoops, there we go. Okay. So, the non-highway. Alright. Well, let's get out there.
With the scouts at Port Zexum.
Which shouldn't be too hard to do. Okay. Oh, the boat's back. Let's see what we get.
Take a look at this.
Aww.
Let's do this one run, get some style, guys.
Ooh. Hold on. Still missing one thing out of it. Let's go.
Scout ship settings.
Okay. Which way are we going? That way. Okay.
What's the matter, Lafayette? You look like you're not feeling well.
Doesn't he always?
You can stay out.
Shut up, Maggie Lou.
You're a demon swordsman. Aizen is a cursed Mala. Maggie Lou is.
Bazaar is right.
But what am I?
Turning existential here.
You're Velvet's tool and emergency rations, aren't you? That's what Lady Teresa called me too. A tool. But I'm alive.
I get it. You're starting to wonder.
Hey, we all come to this question.
There's only one answer. You have to decide it.
Huh?
It's all up to you. It depends on what you want.
That's what it means to be alive. You control the rudder of your life. Your hands on the wheel.
My life. My rudder.
Doubts are okay too. They're just further proof you're alive.
True.
I'll protect you until you find your answer. Your arts have helped me often enough.
All right. I don't really understand. But thank you. Pretty, pretty words and all. But take care who you listen to, kid. Demons and reapers, remember?
I hear there's a wicked witch about, too.
Get going or get left behind.
Ah! We risk the wrath of the revenging reprobate! For now.
I love how overly dramatic she gets. Like life is a show or something. Hi there. There we go. These guys are like no threat.
I'll cut down anyone in my way.
Ooh, one of those. Let's do it. There we go.
Let's go.
Thank you. Weapon dealer, enhance. Hold on. What can we get? Calcite paper. Okay, one of those. An ember doll. Calcite daggers. Yeah. Enhance. I don't have any stuff. Okay. Ooh, a treasure chest. There we go. Let's make our way around.
Did the Sylph J reach your men?
Yeah, they're scouting the checkpoints.
They're not back yet?
No, but they won't be long.
Let's rest for a bit. I'm hungry.
Yeah, me too.
We'll rest until the scouts are back then.
I gave the boy an apple too. Aren't I the kindest girl alive?
An apple.
Would you like one? This time I want you to crow like a
No, thank you.
Miss, are you really planning to fight Artorias?
Well, the boy did ask me so sweetly.
But you have no chance!
Are you defying me? Did the old man give you orders? Then you're coming with me. If things get too hot, we can run. And if we die, then...
That's that. I know.
You're a quick one, little Bianfu. But I do hope you'll struggle as long as possible. I need you around for when I'm bored.
That doesn't sound ominous at all.
Is it good?
It's tart, and yet sweet.
No thanks. I wouldn't be able to taste it anyway.
Oh.
You sure like the sea?
I'm afraid of the sea, the waves, sharks.
Strange fish would be a reason to like the sea.
But at the same time, it's huge and full of wonder. When I let myself think about what might be over the horizon, it's exciting.
My brother, he loved the sea too.
Your brother? Really?
He'd sit on the cape, just staring at it. I told him he'd catch cold in that ocean wind, but he never listened to a word I said. Your way of looking at the world is so much like his. I wish I'd bought him that compass. I wish we could have traveled together like he wanted.
The scouts are back, everyone!
Mafiset, you know you don't have to do this if you don't want to.
I'm going with you, Velvet.
I see.
Well, let's go find out what the scouts found.
You say he was using a pendulum?
Aye, sir. And he blasted all the inspectors. I think he'd be a match for even the captain.
Thank you. I'll look into this for myself.
Hold it. What's going on?
The Exorcist inspection team was attacked by a
pendulum.
The same type of weapon was found at the place the captain vanished from.
And so you think the attacker is the one who took the captain?
I don't know, but this can't be coincidence.
Ifrit is in the custody of Exorcists. Why would they attack
him?
What will you do? One of your keys is running off.
I'm going after him. If they're already in disarray, causing more confusion will only benefit us.
Pandemonium!
Sounds like fun.
Eisen sure picked an inconvenient time to run off, though, didn't he?
I can't blame him. He's got his own purpose.
Let me save real quick. Actually, before we find this pendulum wielding Malak, I think I will end the part here. There we go. Okay. So, I'll see you guys later.